It is scary to be a youth in this time. It is scary to think that a lot of adults are not taking the climate crisis seriously. And I don't want to be scared. I don't want my kids to be scared.
I started climate striking in front of the White House. Every single Friday, I went out there, and when Biden was elected for office, I got a call from the White House, and now they wanted me to be a part of the administration to help usher America's transition to clean energy. And I'm the youngest White House advisor in U.S. history.
I first got involved at the age of 12 when I was first diagnosed with heart palpitations and irregular heartbeat due to the air pollution and smog pollution that ravaged Los Angeles. And for me, it was a moment of realization that a lot of my community members, including I, weren't able to breathe.
I got involved in the climate movement, I always say, through my parents, because they met in the first Earth Summit in 1992. So I kind of have climate activism in my veins, if you could say that. In 2015, my hometown was hit by heavy rainfall. I saw the biggest flood that we've ever had. I realized that we are more powerful than we think we are.
My message to the politicians would be to really take a look at the commitments that every country has made and act on them. Continue to raise the bar.
What I want to tell leaders is that we know that before arriving to COP26, you have already drafted what your increase in ambition will be. I want them to internalize the urgency that we are feeling as a younger generation, and I want them to increase their ambition.
Right now, we aren't seeing major action or really any key promises from world leaders. And we don't need to hear plans for what you think you might do, but actually give us plans about what you're actively doing, where you're actively funding, and what you're actually building. That is what we need. We don't need any more empty speeches, pretty words.
My administration is working overtime to show that our climate commitment is action, not words.
Climate anxiety is a tough thing to explain. For me, it's the uncertainty that there might not be a future for us.
By 2050, we will know whether we have succeeded or failed in addressing the climate crisis. And it is really scary to think about the fact that my kids are going to have an uncertain future.
We are growing up in a society where literally us turning 30 and 40, we'll have a planet that's drastically different from our parents. And I think that's what drives me, is that, and it kind of drives our entire generations, because we can't turn away from this. This is literally our future. We have so little time to take action, but the solutions are here.